Welcome once again to our video daily devotions, Good Shepherd Lutheran Church in Lincoln, Nebraska. I'm Pastor Poppy. Thanks for tuning in. Today, our Bible reading takes us to the Old Testament reading for the third Sunday of Easter. Once again, to the book of Ezekiel, Ezekiel 34. For thus says the Lord God, behold, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As a shepherd seeks out his flock when he is among his sheep that have been scattered, so will I seek out my sheep, and I will rescue them from all places where they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. And I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries. And I will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the ravines, and in all the inhabited places of the country. I will feed them with good pasture, and on the mountain heights of Israel shall be their grazing land. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and on rich pasture they shall feed on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I myself will make them lie down, declares the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, and the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them in justice. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We have a beautiful picture here in Ezekiel 34 of the Good Shepherd. Note how twice in our short text, God says that he and he alone is the Good Shepherd. I myself will shepherd the sheep. Why does God do this? Throughout the pages of Ezekiel, Jeremiah as well, God has harsh words for shepherds who do not tend to the sheep. Shepherds who neglect the sheep. Shepherds who let the sheep wander off and never look for them. Shepherds who feed the sheep something less than good pasture and pure water. God knows what needs to be done. God knows that he himself needs to do it, needs to accomplish our salvation. And that's exactly what he does. The Father sends his Son, clothed in human flesh, to be the Savior of the world. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, who lives and dies and rises from the dead, wins salvation for all people. Jesus is the Good Shepherd, and he is also the Passover Lamb. Remember the words of John? Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. The shepherd dies for sheep who love to wander. The shepherd offers himself as the sacrificial death for sheep who stray. That's you and me. My friends, God has done all of this in and through the person, true God and true man, and the work, life, death, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus. And now the Father and the Son send the Spirit that points us to the completed work of Jesus for salvation. The Spirit provides for us word and sacrament, green grass, pure pastures where we can rest and eat and enjoy and be satisfied. Why? Because we are a part of God's flock. Sheep who have been redeemed, sheep who are taken care of by their good shepherd. This is why we demand from our pastors, our shepherds, that only the pure word of God be proclaimed and taught, and only the sacraments be administered according to the command and promise of God. This is what the Good Shepherd has laid out for us until he returns again in power and might and glory. So, what should we do? We should feast. We should enjoy. We should revel in the pastures of the forgiveness of sins that God has provided for us. My friends, you are part of God's flock. Have no fear, little flock, for the Father has promised to give you the kingdom. Have no fear, little flock. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Amen.
Sinners implore you
to hear us, O Lord,
to rule and govern your holy Christian church, to preserve all pastors and ministers of your church in the true knowledge and understanding of your wholesome word, and to sustain them in holy living, to put an end to all schisms and causes of offense, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived, to beat down Satan under our feet, to send faithful laborers into your harvest, and to accompany your word with your grace and spirit.
We implore you to hear us, Lord.
To raise those who fall, and to strengthen those who stand, and to comfort the weak-hearted and the distressed.
We implore you to hear us, good Lord.
To give to all peoples concord and peace, to preserve our land from discord and strife, to give our country your protection in every time of need, to direct and defend our president and all in authority, to bless and protect our magistrates and all our people, to watch over and help all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation, to protect and guide all who travel, to grant all women with child and all mothers with infant children increasing happiness in their blessings, to defend all orphans and widows and provide for them, to strengthen and keep all sick persons and young children, to free those in bondage, and to have mercy on us all.
We implore you to hear us, good Lord.
To forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts, to give and preserve for our use the kindly fruits of the earth, and graciously to hear our prayer.
We implore you to
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God,
we implore you to hear us.
Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world,
have mercy.
Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world,
have mercy.
Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world,
grant us your peace.
O Christ,
hear us.
O Lord,
have mercy.
O Christ,
have mercy.
O Lord, deal with us according to our sins.
Do not reward us according to our iniquities.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you desire not the death of a sinner, but rather that we should turn from our evil ways and live. Graciously spare us those punishments which we by our sins have deserved, and grant us always to serve you in holiness and pureness of living. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen.